Hey, good morning, guys. Just real quick word of encouragement. This morning, the Lord really put it on my heart to listen to him through the life of Joshua. And really quickly, the Lord was just pointing out to me things that we can stand by. Do all the Lord commands us to do. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. God goes before us, and he is always behind of us. That we are not to be discouraged. For whatever it is that we need to do through the Lord, God will choose the place. The children, the lost, the tribes, the nations that are in our cities, they must hear the word of God, and it's got to come through us. It is not man, but it is the Lord who commissions and anoints everyone. He calls us into a royal priesthood, right? The Lord himself will be with us, Joshua said. Joshua was telling the priest, tell the priest who carried the Ark of the Covenant. Correction, the Lord was telling Joshua. Tell the priest who carried the Ark of the Covenant to go and stand in the river. And this morning the Lord was just putting it on my heart that we are the priest. Where are we stepping out into in our region today? In this week, in the months to come, that we are to step into the flow of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is the river. We don't have to carry the Ark of the Covenant because we are the temple of God and we carry his presence in us. So where is it that you need to go stand at today? The Lord was also just kind of speaking to me this morning in Joshua chapter 3, when the priests were going to step out into the river, you know, where they stood at, the water stopped so that the entire nation could cross over. So where is it that the Lord is placing you at today? And I just want to encourage you to stand there a little bit longer when you feel the itch, whether it be through prayer, through your quiet time, or in the middle of your day, if the Lord says, stand right here, I just encourage you to stand just a little bit longer because the Lord wants everybody that needs to cross over right there to cross over. This was during harvest time at that as well. Said that it was during the floodplains of the Jordan, which was the highest level that it was going to reach at. But in Joshua chapter 3, verse 16, it said, the water from upstream stopped flowing. It piled up in a heap a great distance away at a town called Adam. So right now I want to encourage you that, like, sometimes we can view Adam as sin. We can view Adam, you know, as the first man. We can view him as dirt because he had to be the lowest on earth. You know, like, he had already been cast out of the garden. But Adam goes all the way back to creation. So is there a dream or vision that the Lord has put on your heart that he has created from a long ago? I want to encourage you to dig that up. Take the dirt off of that dream or that vision and step out into the river. Step out into the flow of Holy Spirit, and that where he has you stand at today, gather 12 stones. You know, those 12 stones were to encourage generations to come on just the greatness and the glory of God and just how mighty his ways are. So in your life today, where is it that you need to gather 12 stones so that in future generations that folks will look back and ask you, and then you will be able to just talk about the glory of God and how good he was during this season. And you know, just as this river was flowing, that the Levites, the priests, had to step into during harvest time. On their calendar, it was in April and May. We're almost to the end of April, folks, and we're getting ready to step out into May. So where is it that the Lord is telling us all as a body that it's time to prepare for a harvest? Be encouraged. Know that the Lord is going to place you there and that the water is going to stop for a moment, but that is because where he places you, he wants everybody to cross. He wants everybody to step into that promised land. And where were they stepping to? They were stepping into an opposition. They were once again going to look at Jericho. So once he brings you across, I encourage you, don't give up on the first try. He's calling you to do it 7 times. Completion. Completion. He wants you to step into it. So know that the first time that you speak the word of God, you're releasing power. And if you don't see God move in that moment, have faith and know that He is moving. But that each time that you cry out to Him, each time that you speak this, each time you walk around opposition or the struggle in your way, if you have got to walk around that city 7 times, know that each time you are releasing power. Just like Elijah went up on the mountaintop and he had to cry out 7 times, he birthed something in creation. So where the Lord is calling you to release power today, release power. Where He is calling you to stand still and have faith and be strong and be courageous. But guys, we're coming into a harvest. He is going to prepare the way. He is going to stop the flow of the opposition that would prevent you from crossing over into your promised land. So what's on your heart today? What is your promised land? Ask God. Have faith. Declare the word of God over it. I love you. I hope this has something to do for your life today. I hope this speaks to you. It speaks to me hardcore. So I'm going to step out into my city today. I'm going to step out into my river today. And I'm going to gather 12 stones. I'm going to gather 12 men. And I'm going to gather 12 men. And we're going to come together united. And we're going to declare the word of God over the city. And we're going to have faith that God is going to continue to just bring the homeless out of captivity. That these are going to be fertile lands, that this is a valley that's just going to flow not only with milk and honey, but it's going to flow with restoration, it's going to flow with peace, and it's going to flow with a revival, and it's got to start. I love you guys. God bless you.